We are the armies of God. Yeshua is coming very soon. Amen. Let us pray. Our heavenly, gracious, and loving Father, Yeshua, the Savior King, King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, we praise and adore your holy name. We come before your throne of grace to ask for forgiveness and deliverance for whatever sins that we have committed. May you forgive us, O God. May you remove the spirit that is not of you. Deliver us, O God, from any sins that we have committed. May you guide us, Lord Jesus. May your Holy Spirit guide and lead us, praising and worshiping you without any blemish. Lord, we would like to thank you, Lord, for giving us the opportunity to glorify your name through our songs and praises. We commit to you our service in this morning. May you pour out your fresh anointing to each and every one of us, your singers, dancers, musicians, technicians, from our pastors, ministry leaders, and all the members of our church. May you, Lord, anoint us. And Lord, we entrust to you that we will sing and glorify only your name, Jesus. Great are you, Lord. You overcame the power of death. How strong and mighty you are in this battle. As you said in your words in Deuteronomy 24, for the Lord your God is he who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies to give you the victory. Amen. And 1 Corinthians 15:57, but thanks be to God who give us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Lord, we will shout and proclaim the victory of blood of the Lamb Jesus Christ against the power of darkness and sins. We will continue to ask you, Father, to give us the power and authority to defeat the enemy in Jesus' name. Father, we will continue to worship you because you are our way maker, miracle worker, and the promise keeper, the great healer, the God of possible, and the Son of the living God. You deserve the highest honor, praise, and glory. We thank you, Father. We thank you, sweet Holy Spirit. All glory and honor belongs to you. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, I just want to ask, how are you today? How do you feel today? Amen. For we may not know what you're experiencing right now. I believe that God knows your heart. Not God knows your pain, your fear, your struggles, your battles. And in His name, there's healing, there's deliverance, there's that we have overcome. And in the name of Jesus, there is peace, there is breakthrough, there is revival. And in the name of Jesus, there is life. Amen.
Speak the name of Jesus.
You are a Jehovah.
In humble adoration.
in Romans 8:26 to 27. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know what to pray for as we ought, but the Spirit Himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. And He who searches hearts knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for His saints according to the will of God. As I pray and as I worship, I ask the Lord, Lord, open my spiritual eyes so I will see what is in store for us, what is in store for my life. And I saw a fire, and I saw a tree which has light. God is speaking to us today in prayer. We should be a light unto the world. There should be no hint of wickedness in us. The Lord wants us to be cleansed by His precious blood, so we can operate in the Holy Spirit. Lord Jesus, You remind us, unless the Holy Spirit's anointing is in us, we cannot operate in Your kingdom. Lord, help us to overcome our flesh, that we will truly worship and honor You with all our lives. Lord, any part of us which is not surrendered unto You, Lord, we declare that we ourselves will submit to You. Your word says, submit to Him. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. Lord Jesus, You want us to be sanctified by Your precious blood. All spirit which is not of You is casted out in the name of Jesus. Any spirit of sickness, spirit of hatred, spirit of unforgiveness, any spirit of deception, spirit of selfish ambition, all this spirit is not from You, Lord Jesus. So Father God, stir up the fire in us, that this Holy Spirit will truly operate in us in fullness, so that, Lord, we can cast out demons, we can heal the sick. Lord, Father God, let it be that we will be a tree that is full of light, God. So Lord, we ask for forgiveness. There are sins that we are not aware of. Lord, we ask for forgiveness. We repent. As Peter said, repent and be baptized in one of You for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the power of the Holy Spirit. Lord, Father God, anything which we do not know that it is a sin, we ask for forgiveness, of God. Humble us before You, because You are humble and meek, Lord Jesus. So, Father God, we declare that each one of us will truly be cleansed by Your precious blood, that we will be a tree planted in the streams of water, that we will yield fruit, Lord Jesus. We declare that every empty seed right now, God, will be filled with the souls in Your name. Lord, teach us how to catch them. Teach us, Lord, how to depend on You. For without You, we are nothing, Lord Jesus. So, Father, we pray, even the nations are in rage, in war, such a full of hatred. Lord, Father God, we only can come unto You. We pray for all the churches. We pray for the believers around the world. This is a time to unite in prayer. This is not a time, Lord, for being relaxed, but being in unity in prayer. So, Father God, teach us, as Your people, that there will be unity in prayer. So, Lord Jesus Christ, we know that You are coming very soon. Teach us how to prepare ourselves, O God. Lord, to meet ourselves at You. Lord, humble us. Reveal to us, Lord, Your glory. In these times of grief, in these times, Lord, of wars, humors of wars, we pray for our leaders. We pray for those who are in authority around the world, that truly they will come to know that the saving grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray for Israel, we pray for Palestine, we pray for China. Lord, that the power of greed will be broken, that the power will be used for good purpose. Lord Jesus, we speak and demolish the spirit of wealth and power by those wild authorities. So Lord Jesus Christ, we will be defeated by your precious blood. Lord, we pray for our dear brethren who are not around. Lord, let the spirit of weakness, let the spirit of sickness will be overcome by your precious blood, Lord Jesus. There's no way that the sickness can hinder us in worshiping and honoring you. So Lord Jesus Christ, we pray for those who do not have job. We pray for those who become weak. We pray for those who need hope. You are our greatest hope, Lord Jesus Christ. We pray for those who mourn because they are comforted. You, Lord, says. So Father God, comfort your people. Let there be peace, the peace that comes from you. Because the peace that the world cannot give is temporary. But the peace that you, Lord Jesus Christ, is giving us is an eternal peace. So Lord Father God, we also pray as our dear Pastor Boyo will share your word. Let there be anointing and power that the declaration, Lord, will sink into our hearts. And we will put into practice, O God. Because Lord, the enemy is already defeated by your precious blood, Lord Jesus. So Father, as you speak, the devil cannot overcome. Because we are overcomers in your name, Lord Jesus Christ. So Father God, would you teach us and humble us? We don't know how to pray as your word says, but Lord, the Holy Spirit will intercede with groans in us so that we will be able to pray what you want us to pray. So Father God, teach us, Lord, how to be fruitful. Because in this world, darkness is increasing day by day. When people become hopeless, when people, many people even wanted to kill themselves because we don't have a Savior. We don't have the Lord Jesus Christ. So Father God, would you reveal to us these people, especially in this nation of Oman, God. We pray that the spirit of divorce will be broken and many people will come to know you. So Lord Jesus, as we look around, there are people who are in stress, but they cannot open up. You, Lord Jesus, will reveal to us. Because, Lord, the Holy Spirit is in us. So, Lord, help us. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that till now we have breath. Thank you that until now you sustain us. Father, there is a purpose why we are here. Apart from our jobs, Lord, you want us, Lord, to show that light that comes from you. So truly, Lord, we will be a tree of life, that we will shine, Lord, in the midst of this dark world. So Father God, we just thank you. As we await for your word, let this be our nourishment of our spirit. So Lord, we will be stirred up in serving you, Lord. We thank you for this dark moment that until now, you have given us, Lord, the sustenance. We are here because it is you, Lord, who have brought us here. It is by your power and it is by your purpose that we are here. So we entrust you, Lord Jesus. We pray for our fellow pastors and elders and all the ministries that are serving you, Lord Jesus. Lord, we will be faithful. We will continue to work for your kingdom. As your word says, those who will endure unto the end will receive the eternal promise in heaven. So Lord Jesus Christ, let each one of our ministries will work with all the heart of Jesus. Because the reward is not of this world. The reward is in heaven. So we just entrust to you, Lord, all the things and even the plans of the church, Lord, in the next months to come. We trust you.